Hi, today I am going to be planting out some little seedlings. Some of them are still a bit tender. It's only the beginning of March, so it's not really the best time to be planting out some tender plants. But I've kind of run out of room and they're outgrowing, so they're going to have to go out. But I've got a few plans to protect them, so I'll show you what I'm going to do while I'm on my way. We're going to start with sweet corn. So I'll just turn the camera around and then you can see what I'm doing. So here's my little sweet corn that I started growing in toilet roll inners because they don't like having their roots disturbed. And as you can see, the roots are getting quite long now. So they need to be going out and they're looking a bit brown. So I don't want them to die. So I'm going to plant them out. I've already planted some. I'll show you where I've planted them. I'll get my shadow out of the way. So I've planted one here, and then another one over there, and then another one over there. And with sweet corn, it's important to plant them in blocks rather than rows, because they're wind pollinated. So you need to make sure that they've got a good chance of getting some pollination, and planting them in blocks is the best way to do that. Now, I'm not very good at planning my garden, so I'm just popping them in where I've got some space. So I've got three there, and then I'm going to do four or five at this end if I can find spots for them. So I shall get on with that and I'll show you when I've done. Okay, I've managed to get a block of four in there, and then I've got a block of four there. So we've got one, two, three, four. And I'll show you my little plan to protect them. I've got some of these sweetie jars that I just got from a shop that didn't need them anymore. So overnight, and if it's particularly cold, that's what I shall do. I shall cover them over. It's got its very own little mini greenhouse, and I'm hoping that will protect it enough from any cold weather. Okay, now I'm going to be planting out my broccoli that I potted on in my previous video, if you saw me do that. This is what they're like now, a few weeks later, and they're ready to go out into the garden. They are more cold hardy than the sweet corn, so I don't have to worry too much about protecting these. They've actually been out in these pots, in just this box, for a few weeks now, and they've been fine, and they're coming along nicely. So again, I'm just going to try and find some room in the garden for them, and then I'll show you where I've put them when I've put them. I've also got some red Russian kale, so I'm going to plant that out with the broccoli as well. That's ready to go in as well. So I think what I'm going to do is plant the brassicas together, and then when butterfly season comes, I can net them and try and keep the butterflies off. I don't know how well you can see that. I'm just going to show you. I've got four buckwheats there, and then I'm going to put some kale in between. I need to find like little gaps, because you may remember that I made this into a hugel culture, so there's sticks below the ground there. So I'm just trying to find little holes between the sticks. So, can you see that? Can you see that? There we go. It's just to show you that the roots are now coming round the bottom of the plant, which means that they are ready to go into the ground. So I shall pop that in there. I think I need an eating pad. It's getting hard. Right, another one. There we go. Oh, that was an easy bit. This is red Russian kale. I have got some other varieties. I've got some Cavello Nero kale, which I think is called dinosaur kale in America, and I've got some curly kale as well. So we should have quite a selection when they all get going. Okay, I think I'm just going to do those two rows there, because I've got another row of broccoli seedlings coming through, so I'm going to leave some room to transplant some of those. So I'm just going to go and have a wander around the garden and find some more little spots to put them, and I'll come back later. Okay, so I've got my little rows there. I've separated out some of the seedlings as well, and I managed to plant some things down in my little border at the bottom. So I've got some broccoli there, and a kale, and then another kale and another broccoli, and then I've put some rocket around the edge there. So that should fill up nicely later on, and it should look quite nice. And I'm off to find some more spots, because I've still got some left. Okay, so I found some more space for my last few broccolis and kales, and I've just planted them here. I don't know if you can see that. There we go. And there's another one. I've just chopped and dropped some comfrey as well to feed the ground there, because it was looking a bit dry and hard. So hopefully they'll do all right there, and we'll see how they get on throughout the season. And let me know how you're getting on with your seeds and seedlings. Is your garden taking shape now? Things coming along? Let me know in the comments, and I'll see you again next time.